Astromonies.com. It's actually been a while since I actually did a live video, and just wanted to shoot one with the topic of how to brand yourself online and how to get over your fear of doing videos. So as you guys are hopping on, make sure that you drop me a comment where you guys are watching from, and I'll definitely love to give you a shout out. So what's going on, Jason? How are you doing? So the topic I wanted to talk to you guys about is how do you brand yourself online and initially get over that fear of doing videos, especially when you're first getting started. If you haven't done any videos yet, maybe this live video can help you to get over that initial fear that you feel when you're trying to do videos or try to start to brand yourself online and start to, you know, do the things that will build your audience, engage your audience, and sell to your audience when you're actually looking to build your business online. So I was actually reading a pretty awesome book. It's called Expert Secrets by Russell Brunson. And one of the chapters that I wanted to share with you guys was, I picked up this lesson where in the book he says, it's important to understand that when you first start, you're not posting these for your audience. You're posting them for you. Eventually, people will start to follow, but initially, it's so you can discover your own voice. So when you're branding yourself online, it's important to ask yourself a few questions before you get started. So you have to take the time to really figure out who you are, what you stand for, and figure out who do you really want to serve. So when you start to ask yourself these questions, you'll start to realize, okay, there's a specific audience that I vibe with the most. There's a specific audience that can resonate with your message, and because everyone has a unique story. So if you take a look at my own personal story, so I grew up in Hawaii. I was an island boy. My parents immigrated from the Philippines and moved to Hawaii in order to be able to give their children a better life in America. So if you guys know this, the Philippines is a third world country, and my parents were both one of 10 children. So you can imagine growing up with, you know, 9 other brothers and sisters, and just realizing that, you know, they're living in a poverty established country. So they moved to America with a dream of giving their children a better life and a better lifestyle so that they can so that my brother and I can have the things that they've never had growing up. And they wanted to give their children the experience of that lifestyle. So that's a little bit of background on me. And then I graduated from high school, the first thing that I did is actually move to the Northeast for college, where my dad has his family side in New York, and my mom's side was all in Hawaii. So I wanted to be able to experience that different lifestyle. And I, you know, when I went to engineering school, I picked up a few skills in college that I really wanted to learn. Like, I've never learned how to dance. So when I was in college, there was a breakdancing crew that was giving free lessons, as well as a ballroom club that did salsa lessons. So if you go into that, a little bit of my story, you'll start to see that people can resonate with things that have happened in my own personal life. So if people are either Filipino, or if they grew up in Hawaii, if they moved to the Northeast, they learn how to break dance, they know how to snowboard, any of those different skill sets, the people that will vibe with that are the people the people that I would resonate with are the people who, you know, have that in common. It's one of those things in common with my own personal story. So when you figure out, you know, who you are, what you stand for, and who do you want to serve, just realize that the people that you serve are going to be kind of similar to you. Like today, I'm 30 years old now, and I have a 9-month-old. So I never thought that I'd have a son at this age, but it nonetheless, life happened, and I can now resonate more with young parents or other people with families or other people with young children. So as you guys are hopping on, make sure you guys drop me a comment. What's going on, Leah Ray? What's going on, Matt? So sharing your own personal story can help you to relate more to your audience. You want to be, you know, a source of hope for other people. If you've gone through a struggle in your life, if you've gone through something that was very trying when you went through it, you can actually help the people who are, you know, going through that challenge or that adversity right now. So you have value to share with other people, even if you don't think you do, because everybody's story is unique, everybody has different life experiences, and everybody can learn from other people's life experiences. And you want to be able to incorporate that in your own personal brand when you're doing it online. It makes you more relatable. If you're vulnerable to other people, it'll show in your videos, it'll show through your content, it'll show through any interactions that you have with other people. So you want to be able to give people a sense of hope and realize that there's light at the end of the tunnel. It's not just gonna be darkness all the time. You want to be able to provide value to other people through your own personal story and through your own journey. So how this relates to getting over your fear of doing video: if you're looking to brand yourself online, you want to be able to find your own unique voice. When you brand yourself online, you know who you are, you know who you stand for, you know who you serve, then getting over the fear of doing videos is just to focus, is put the focus, instead of putting the focus on yourself and your own fears, instead of thinking, you know, that, you know, what if people don't like what I share? What if people don't like me? What if I say something stupid? What if I don't say the right thing? These are all thoughts that are all focused on you, and they're all in here. They're all in your head, and it's not something that can help serve other people. Instead of putting the focus on yourself, when you start to do videos, the way that you can get over them quickly is to just realize that you want to be there to help other people. So put the focus on serving other people instead of thinking to yourself that you're not good enough, you're not worthy to be able to shoot a quick video or do a Facebook Live, for example. Because when you're focused on helping other people, the fear dissipates in your mind. And the funny thing about fear is it doesn't exist in our external environment. Everything that we experience when we experience fear is really built up in our heads, and it's something that you have to, you know, be able to work on and just realize that if you let fear stop you from doing a video, then you're not sharing your message with the world. You're not able to share your voice with other people, and you're not able to help other people who can benefit from the message that you have to share and the different life experiences that you've personally been through and the different adversities that you've had when it comes to, you know, your own life journey. So the quickest way that you can get over that fear is really to just put the focus on helping and serving other people, because you can't feel the fear and focus on serving other people at the same time. It's funny when that happens. You want to be able, if you try to serve other people, then you get out of your own head and you stop being afraid of staring at a camera and actually sharing your voice, your message, your own life experiences with the world. So if you are looking to build your brand online, just realize that you have to figure out who you are, what you stand for, and who you want to serve. And when you do that, people will resonate with you. The right people who can relate to your journey, can relate to your own personal adversities, they'll be able to relate to your message. And just realize that you don't have to attract everyone. You want to be able to attract the right people who actually resonate with you. You're not gonna be able to make everybody like you. You want to find the right people who can resonate with you and who actually do vibe with your message. So I hope that this video has been helpful for you guys. If you guys get value from it, drop me a V in the comments, and make sure that you hop on my newsletter at destrimonies.com/newsletter. If you get value from the content that I'm sharing with you guys through, you know, either Facebook posts or even live Facebook live videos. And I hope that you find your voice, find who you are, who you stand for, and who you want to serve, because I want to see you guys be able to help serve other people and just make, and really to just make the world a better place. And you can do that by just sharing your own personal stories, by being vulnerable and being authentic when it comes to your own personal life journey. So hope you guys get value from this video. Make sure you hop on my newsletter if you guys get value, and I'll catch you guys later. Have a good night.